Hare Krishna, Pandur Pranam Guru Maharaj.
I still remember the first time when I met you. Previous to that, I was having a great craving to know who would be my Guru Maharaj after I had attended Bhagavatam at Jagannath Puri. The day I met you, just before that, I was listening to your bhajans of Krishna Bhavanamrit. And when I told my brother that I really want to go to the temple, to Kolkata temple, ISKCON, he told me that I can go with him in the evening because Bhakti Charya Swami Maharaj is coming for a lecture. And I was like, he's the same Maharaj, no? Who's Tulsi Manjari's Guru Maharaj? And brother said, yes. I said, I'll definitely join you. And I and my brother Rasraj Gopal Das, I remember having gone to the temple, and the moment I entered the chokhat of the temple, I remember I looked up, and when I saw Maharaj, as if there was a spark that happened. When my eyes met with Guru Maharaj's eyes, it seems very dramatical, but it's true that it happened. At least that was what I perceived. I spontaneously told my brother that I would like to have Tulsi beads. I want to wear them. And he was quite astonished at such a demand at such a time. But I told him that I really want it. And I want it means I want it. And he told me that, are you aware that once you wear Tulsi Mala, you cannot have onion and garlic? And I said, I know that. I'm aware. But I want it right now. He got it from the temple shop. I took the Tulsi Mala, got it offered by His Grace Anand Mohan Prabhuji at the altar of Radha Govindji, and took it from Maharaj's hand. I told Maharaj boldly, I'll take initiation from you only. My brother was looking at me and he was wondering that what do I think of myself. Maharaj smiled and said, give her my email ID. And one of the devotees gave me the email ID of Guru Maharaj. I stayed in touch with Guru Maharaj. I remember once having taken my dad to the temple and making him meet Guru Maharaj, telling him that, you know, this is the person who would be my spiritual master. I got a lot of opportunities to serve Guru Maharaj under the meticulous guidance of Her Grace Shamangi Mataji. I remember my first service at Mataji's Sopanbagh house in Pune, where Mataji told me that the simplest thing that you can do is probably iron for Maharaj, and I did that. And because it was for Maharaj, I just thought that, you know, I hope whatever I do is good. I remember having made sandesh for Guru Maharaj. I remember having done dusting in his room, cleaning his room, washroom, everything. I mean, I'm so grateful to Shamangi Mataji for giving me such an opportunity to always serve Maharaj whenever he was in Pune, for remembering me and considering me worthy of serving Maharaj. I remember once having taken muskmelon for Maharaj and asking Shamangi Mataji the permission to make juice out of muskmelon so that we could offer it to Maharaj. And Mataji told me, you only make it. And I was like, I am not so sure whether I'll be able to handle your mixer. But finally, I got help from Aishwarya and we made it. And when it was offered to Maharaj, Maharaj really appreciated. So it felt so nice. And the most amazing thing about Maharaj was that before having his breakfast, he asked that if all of us had had. Although we had not had, but we said we did because we wanted Maharaj to eat first. It's been a wonderful, wonderful experience of serving Maharaj. Maharaj has always been so loving, so caring. And the qualities which drew me towards Maharaj were his humility, his love for his Guru Maharaj, and his love for everyone. That I could always see a father figure in Bhakti Charya Swami Maharaj, and that is why I wanted to, you know, be initiated by him. It was always the mercy of Shamangi Mataji that I got to serve Maharaj. Maharaj gave me a few instructions. The first one was to do 8 rounds and read Krishna book, which I did when he told me to. And then he told me to chant, complete my rounds before breakfast. After saying which, he smiled at me because probably he knew that it would be really tough for me. He once asked me, when I told him that I'm quite dissatisfied with everything, although I have, you know, materially achieved a lot of degrees, but still I feel dissatisfied. He told me I could come to Ujjain and serve him. I told him that that's quite difficult because my husband is based in Pune. So he told me that I could serve in Pune. And I started serving. Due to my job, at times I had to, you know, give a little less attention on services, but I always continued attending classes in the temple and doing whatever service as and when I could do. Maharaj, I pray to you that may I be able to serve Radharani and Krishna under the able guidance of Srila Prabhupada. Please keep blessing us all so that we grow stronger and stronger in bhakti, serve Guru and Gauranga till our last breath. Your little silly, absolutely hopeless daughter, Radha Jyoti. Missing you, Maharaj. Hare Krishna.